Hello. Today, let us discuss protection of solids. In solids, we have two types. One is prisms. Another one is pyramids. Prism means it will have one base at the bottom, one base at the top, and the lateral surfaces are vertical and they are rectangular in shape. Whereas in pyramids, we have only one surface at the bottom and an apex at the top. And here, apex being connected to all the corners of the base. You can observe here, they are all triangular in shape. In pyramids, I am talking about the pyramids. In pyramids, we have all the surrounding surfaces are triangular in shape and they are square. Whereas in prisms, the lateral surfaces are straight and they are rectangular in shape. Prism will have a base at the bottom and top surface at the top. Whereas in pyramid, we have only base at the apex, base at the bottom and apex at the top. And apex being joined to all the corners of the base. And these surfaces are triangular and they are slant. This is a basic feature of a pyramid. In that, we let us consider an example of square pyramid. Okay. Square pyramid, here you can observe, this is a square pyramid. You can observe the base is a square. Base is a square in shape and apex we have at the top and this apex is connected to the corner, all the four corners of the base. Okay. And you can observe these surfaces are triangular in shape. Okay. And they are all slant. Okay. This is a square pyramid. Now let us solve a problem on square pyramid. A square pyramid of 30 mm side of base. 30 mm side of base means this edge length. This edge length is 35. And 65 axis length. 65 axis length means from the center of the base to the apex, the height is, axis height is 65. Base side is 35. You can take down the diagram. Base side is 35 and axis is 65 and it is resting on HP. It is resting on HP with one of its edges of the base. It is clearly mentioned, rest on HP with one of its edges of the base. That means it is resting with one of its edges of the base. This is the base, this is the edge. So it is resting with one of the edge of the base on HP. So here the question is, it rests on HP with edge position. So this data is enough to solve the first stage of the solution. This data is enough to solve the first stage of the solution. Okay. So to draw the first stage of the solution, we are going to assume that the solid is resting on HP such that the surface is parallel to HP. So in this position, if you observe from top, that is on HP you can see the top view. If you observe from the top, you can see the square base and the apex. Apex being joined to all the four corners of the base. In the top view, you can see the square surface and the apex which is being connected to all the surface, all the corners of the base. So let us draw the top view. Here is a square.
And name the mass.
position of D is D dash. You can observe here, A and D, they are lying along the same line. A and D are lying along the same line. If you observe from this position, you can see A, but you cannot see D because D lies along the same line. So it becomes zero.
Thank you.
intelligence in one. Third stage, always remember we need both inclination and also we need what is inclined. This completes the three stages.